We want to find Taylor series about x is equal to 0, which is Maclaurin series that will converge to this function for certain values of x, right? So you after you find the Maclaurin series, you will find the interval of convergence. Okay, so as you can see, I already wrote the first couple of terms of the Maclaurin series expansion that we're going to use. And for this, we need a few derivatives that I've already written, right? So the given function is this function, 1 over 1 plus x squared, right? So I found the derivatives here. This should be pretty simple for you to find. In any case, let's find the first few terms. Okay, so the function of 0 is 1. 1 times x to the 0 is 1, right? So it's just 1 over 0 factorial. And I'm just going to remain with factorials because we will need it to see if there's any pattern. Plus, the function, the derivative at 0 is negative, right? So we have to make this a minus. So minus 2 times x divided by 1 factorial. Okay. So let's see. And then plus 6, right? Because notice that 1 plus x, when you plug in 0, it will always be 1 in the denominator, right? So we can basically think of the denominator always as 1, which is fine. Right, so plus 6x squared over 2 factorial plus, well actually minus because there's a minus 24, minus 24 times 24x to the third over 3 factorial, etc., etc. Right, so let's see what that's going to be. From counting from 0 for the k, so let's take care of the factorials. As you can see, factorial always increases by 1, the number in the factorial, right? So we can just write k factorial. That's fine. Now, the signs alternate, right? So we will have negative 1 to the k, right? Not k plus 1, but k, because when k is equal to 0, this becomes positive, which is exactly the numerator. Now, let's take care of the these numbers, the coefficients. So let's see. So notice that this can be, 24 can be expressed as 4 factorial, 6 is 3 factorial, 2 is 2 factorial, 1 is 1 factorial. Right? And 1 factorial is, you see the correlation? There's 1 here, there's 0 here, 2, 1, 3, 2. So this number in the top in the factorial exceeds this one by 1, right? So for this reason, so that means this guy will be 2 plus one, k plus 1 factorial, because it will exceed by 1 the denominator in the same way, right? So that's good, we took care of that. Now let's take care of the x. X is easy, right? Because x power matches exactly the one in the factorial, the number in the factorial in the denominator, right? 3, 3, 2, 2, 1, 1, right? So it's just the same, x to the k. Excellent, but we're not done yet, right? Because we have to simplify. Notice that we can't leave this like that, because we can factor out the k plus 1, right? And the k factorial will cancel out with k factorial in the denominator, right? So we're left with basically negative 1 to the k times k plus 1 times x to the k. Bingo! We don't even have a fraction, right? So that's the Maclaurin series that we found. So now let's find the interval of convergence, that is the x values for which the given series that we just found will converge exactly into this function, right? So using the ratio test, of course, right? Because we're testing for absolute convergence first, right? So one term of the sequence. This is a sequence. Now think of this as a sequence without the summation sign. This is just a sequence divided by the previous term, right? So that's going to be, so we can disregard the negative 1 because the absolute value makes it positive, right? We can just take care of these guys. K plus 2, right? Because K is replaced with K plus 1, right? So it's K plus 1 plus 1, K plus 2 times x to the K plus 1, right? Divided by, copy this down, k plus 1 over x to the k. k plus 1 times x to the k, absolute value closed. So now what do? We have this remaining, right? We have k plus 2 over k plus 1. And there's one extra on the top, x to the k factors out, right? So it's just absolute value x. And why absolute value? Because we're building a series around x value of 0. So that means around about x is equal to 0 means x can be positive or x can be negative or x can be 0, right? So we have to use the absolute value. So now, if you take the limit, you will realize that this is equal to 1. Right, divide the numerator and denominator by the k of the highest power, which is k, you will get 1 plus 2 over k divided by 1 plus 1 over k. And you take the infinity, put the infinity into the k, you will get 1 over 1, right? 1 plus 0 over 1 plus 0, which is 1. So that means 1 will multiply the absolute value of x, so that's the limit value, absolute value of x. And that, according to the ratio test, should be less than 1 in order to guarantee absolute convergence. So that result tells us that using the properties of absolute value, that negative 1 is less than x is less than 1, right? So absolute convergence for negative 1 to 1. But now let's test for conditional convergence the endpoints, the negative 1 and 1. First let's try negative 1 endpoint. So we're going to plug this into the series and see what series we get. Okay, we're going to plug x is equal to negative 1 into the series. So we get negative 1 to the k times k plus 1 times negative 1 to the k. Bingo. Negative 1 to the k is repeated twice. So that means we can stick it under the same k power, both negative 1s. Negative 1 times negative 1, bingo, is 1. 1 to the k is 1, right? So that's it, it's gone. So all we have is k plus 1. So now that you should recognize that this is divergent, right? This is divergent, a divergent series, right? Because if you take the kth term test for divergence, you will see that this is equal to infinity, which is not equal to 0, right? So you will not have satisfied the kth term test for divergence. If it's not equal to 0, it's divergent, right? So we just showed it's not convergent, right? So there's divergence. So not only there's divergence outside of this interval, there's also divergence at x is equal to negative 1, as we just showed, right? There's no way there's convergence there. So let's test the right endpoint, x is equal to 1. So we'll have where's that? That's here. So negative 1 to the k times k plus 1 times 1 to the k. 1 to the k. So what does that mean? That means 1 to the k. So 1 times negative 1, since they have the same power. 1 times negative 1 is negative 1. So negative 1 to the k times k plus 1. Right? So now, what does that mean? Negative 1 to the k. Yeah, so that means here's what we're going to test. We're going to test for convergence taking the absolute value of this. Okay, the absolute. Well, actually, no, we're not going to take the absolute value. We're going to use the alternate series test. Alternate series test would be better. Okay, so the alternating series test, we're just going to take the limit of this, k plus 1. Right? Alternating series test disregards the negative 1 to the k and just deals with the other parts of the sequence, right, which is k plus 1. So we're just going to take limit of this. If this is not equal to 0, then there's divergence, right? And as you can tell, if you plug in infinity, you will get infinity, not equal to 0, right? So alternating series test, first condition is not satisfied. So there's divergence. Divergence of this. And that means the original one, this one, is also divergent. So what did we just show? We showed divergence for both of these endpoints, right? So this result holds for convergence, not just absolutely. There's no conditional convergence at those endpoints, right? So series that we found, this series, so we should say, I'm going to write this for you. So the series that we found, k plus 1 times x to the k, converges in the interval negative 1 to 1. Okay? And divergence for at the endpoints and outside of the interval as well. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.